In community news, Newton Efakasa in Wellington prepared a send-off for their retiring minister, Reverend Risati Sone Ete.
Yes, Reverend Ete and his wife Fereni have served the parish for the past 35 years. And although they still have energy to burn, church governance says a minister must retire upon reaching the age of 70. Did you know that?
No, I didn't. But as Tangalo Tele o Sone Okesene reports, old friends and church members gathered in their honour.
It's possibly the last time to see Reverend Ete leading out, and after 35 years of ministry, which includes an appointment to the Queen's Service Order, retirement brings a happy, sad reaction.
We are very glad to be able to have travelled this long with our people.
For his wife and partner in this ministry, one of Fereni's joys has been working with the children in the Early Childhood Centre and seeing them grow.
Because it started on the 5th of March 1985. And they, well, they're most of them who started their own alma mater are now parents. And that is amazing, you know. You never realize how time is flying.
A small photographic display barely skims the surface of the 35 years. But one of the more tangible legacies they leave behind them is the uniquely Samoan church building that stands out in this neighborhood.
As you can see, the buildings I'm built in Samoan style of fale. This was the vision that we had, that the people should worship God in their own culture and their own language, for them to be able to appreciate religion.
But there's unfinished business here. They retire before the completion of the new Aonga Amata and car park.
The good thing is to know that it is being built and it is shaping up very well. But of course, we will be back sometime next year for its dedication, the opening.
Over the years, it's become a tradition that the Christmas production is written, directed, and produced by Risati Sone and Fereni. But for their final year, this tradition has been broken.
All the ex-pupils, the teachers, and current pupils of the Sunday School decided to give them a rest. And we've put on this production in honor of them and to pay tribute to them.
This is the first time that we're going to sit down and watch and listen.
Beautiful voices. Now I hear they have plans to have a couple of months break in Samoa before returning to fellowship with their church and family. Enjoy the rest.
Yes, a well-deserved rest as well. Ma lolo soifolo susunga fa'afenga male faltua.